Now we have to decide how exactly the groups are identified. The first one method is visual inspection. By inspecting the component, the process planning engineers or production engineers can see the features that are present in the component. It may be having some drilled holes or spherical surfaces. It may be having a cylindrical surface. So based on the visible features, it is possible to allocate it to a particular group. Maybe if it is having all cylindrical surfaces, it can be allocated to a lathe cell or where lathe machines are available. If it is having very high surface finish requirements and where there are flat surfaces, maybe it can be allocated to a cell which is having milling machine and a grinding machine. The next method is by using production flow analysis. In this production flow analysis, the sequence of operations required for a given part or product are first identified. Once the sequence of operations are identified, it can be allocated to a particular group based on the previously available information of a particular group. So which group has got much better matching or the much better sequence of operations available, the particular product can be allocated to a group which is already classified. So the third method is part classification and coding. Parts are studied carefully for their attributes or for their specific characteristics, which can be their design, so mainly related to the features which are present in the component, and it will be matched to the already existing groups and it can be allocated. It is more or less very much similar to the visual inspection, where we are visually looking for some features. The next method is classification and coding is done based on the manufacturing attributes. Again, this is related to the manufacturing processes required to produce the given component. So this will be again related to production, similar to production flow analysis. But whenever we say classification and coding, the design attributes will be given a particular code. Similarly, manufacturing attributes will be given a particular coding, and using this coding alone, the grouping will be done. But in case of the earlier methods, that is a visual inspection and product flow analysis, the code will not be generated initially. They will be inspected and verified, and the allocation of the product to the group will be done. So let us see some example of how the group products can be organized into different groups. So on the left you are having several components, and on the right you are seeing the products arranged into groups. So the first group is the turned components. Basically there are cylindrical components. It is a simple cylinder. This will be a stepped shaft, or this will be a ring. This one is a geometric parts, which means it is made up of simpler geometries or flat surfaces. Simple cuboid. This is will be a bar, and this will be like a stepped surface. So you are having steps. So basically these things can be done on a turning machine or CNC lathe or a conventional lathe. These things can be made on a milling machine, will be more or less sufficient. Then the third group is the formed parts, which is made up of thin material. Usually it is made on a press, where you require a punch and a die to bend the sheet material into the required shape. So based on their operations that are required to make these components, the parts are grouped into three categories. So by inspecting the component, or by understanding the sequence of operations, or by generating a code based on a feature, it is possible to divide the products into various categories, and this methodology is called as group technology. Basically we are grouping the components based on the features that are present.